Harvey Weinstein was taken to a hospital in New York City following his conviction on felony rape and criminal sexual act. Weinstein was headed to Rikers Island Prison when he was rerouted to the hospital to go under observation for high blood pressure and heart palpitations. Weinstein will remain in custody as he awaits his sentencing date on March 11th, where he faces up to 29 years in prison. Joining me now, Midwin Charles, attorney at the law firm Midwin Charles and Associates, and Amber Tamblyn, actress, founding member of the Time's Up movement, and author of the best-selling book, Era of Ignition, Coming of Age in a Time of Rage and Revolution. What was your reaction yesterday?
Shock. I think a lot of the women I know, a lot of the survivors I know, were kind of in a state of shock. Nobody expected for him to be convicted. I think everyone expected for the status quo and the normal thing to happen, which is that he would get off. And I think it was shock and then a lot of feelings, a lot of like joy and anger and frustration. Why wasn't it all five counts? Why was it just two? But then also feeling at the end of the day like, you know, he's not an alleged rapist anymore. Now he is an actual rapist according to the law. And that's a huge deal. This is a revolutionary moment in these kinds of proceedings. Conversations.
Midwin?
Yeah, no, I agree. And one of the reasons why this is huge is because convictions for rape are very rare in America. 3 in 4 women are raped and don't report it. Mm-hmm. 80% of the time, the police do not make an arrest. So right then and there, you are always facing a barrier as to having a prosecution. And even when the police do make an arrest, a lot of times the district attorneys do not prosecute the case. For example, this very district attorney in 2015 failed to prosecute the case of, I think her name was Amber Gutierrez, mm-hmm. who said that Weinstein had grabbed her breast. She went to the police and they believed her. They made her wear a wire, go speak to Weinstein. He admitted it on tape. And this particular district attorney, Cy Vance, decided that he was not going to prosecute Weinstein. So one of the reasons why this is a watershed moment, particularly for the Me Too movement, and congratulations to Tarana Burke and the countless other women who have done the work to raise awareness for victims of sexual assault. But it is a watershed moment because this is someone who is incredibly wealthy, incredibly powerful, and had the means to mount a rigorous defense, right? He's entitled to that. But the idea that someone like him would be convicted in light of the fact that he had so many factors in his favor, excuse me, I think is huge. I think it's important because not only was he prosecuted and held to account for the law, but you had 12 members of the jury composed of men and women who believed those two victims. And that, I think, is huge going forward, because one of the reasons why so many women don't come forward is because they don't think they'll be believed. They don't want the hassle. They don't want the stress. So I commend these women who testified, including Annabella Yura, for basically bearing themselves and putting themselves out there and talking about something that is difficult, something that is triggering. That's another reason why a lot of women don't come forward. They don't want to relive what happened to them. So I commend the women who came forward and decided that, you know what, I'm going to tell my story in the hopes that more victims don't happen. I mean, you're talking about someone where 100 women, triple digits, 100 women have come forward and said that he is in some shape or form sexually assaulted.
And you know what? I saw this really wonderful tweet from my friend and also survivor Ashley Judd, who said, you know, she's very happy that this is the outcome, but she can't help but think about how it took 90 women to get 2 convictions against this guy.
And what's
that
telling?
Yeah, it's mm-hmm. very telling. So while we can still be feeling like there was justice served, there still is a sense of frustration that it wasn't enough. And to your point, it really was the women who put their necks, their careers,
their lives
on the line. I mean, we saw that with the reporting of Ronan Farrow and Megan Toohey and Jodi Kantor. We saw these women come out and to get on the stand, women like Jessica Mann and Annabella, these women who came in and did everything, risked everything to tell their story, knowing that they still may not be believed. And they did that because they wanted this to change.
But then you worry that maybe he'll still be able to game the system. Yesterday, after he was convicted, mm-hmm. he tossed that walker, and he didn't go to Rikers.
Right.
he went to Bellevue, which isn't a nice hospital, right. But it's a whole lot nicer than going to jail. Right. Do you worry that that justice still won't get served?
Well, that's the next hurdle, right? Sentencing, yes. Which is scheduled for March 11th, and we'll see whether or not he will be sentenced to the full extent. With the third-degree rape charge, he's looking at 18 months to 4 years, and with the Criminal Sex Act, he's looking at 5 to 25. I doubt he's going to get the high end of it. That's another thing that I think a lot of people don't realize, is that when it comes to sexual assault cases and rape cases, the actual sentences are not that high. You'd be quite surprised. There are people in jail serving longer sentences for drug use and drug sale than rape, which I think many of us might agree rape is the more serious crime. Mm-hmm. So it would not surprise me if he doesn't get the high end, just because that tends to be the standard for just about everyone else. But what he does need to do is go to Rikers, like everybody else, until he gets that sentence.
What does this do? Does it do anything culturally to your industry, to your business?
I think the fact that yesterday Harvey Weinstein was made an example of the type of behavior in the industry that is unacceptable, but not just in Hollywood, across industries, no matter where you work, that there are punishments, that there can be justice if people do what they did, if women do what they did in this circumstance by putting their bodies and their voices on the line. It's the same thing that happened with the Bill Cosby trial and case. You were seeing women do this as an act of survival, and for sure, it has changed the way in which my industry looks at predatory men, and I hope that this is something that is an example that men will look at and think about their behavior and changing it ultimately in the long run.
Well, your bravery, your work, your advocacy is certainly helping change that. Thank you both so
much. Thank you.
I really appreciate it. Coming up, Senator Bernie Sanders.